We've successfully buried a massive bunker underneath my backyard, but with that success comes a tiny predicament. If you remember seeing the giant culvert bunker tubes flying through the air, as we lowered them into the hole we dug in my backyard, those tubes had a black exterior waterproofing coating on the outside that helps keep the metal intact while it's underground for the next 100 years. That coating, however, burns away if we do any welding on the inside wall of the tube, which means now that the bunker is 17 feet below ground, we can't weld any of the inner walls to the outer walls unless we want to dig it all up and recoat the outside. And that is something I definitely do not want to do. I think we have a solution, however, that involves a skeleton, so hopefully it works. And at the end of this video, we should have a complete off-grid, electrically powered underground bunker. This dark and dingy cave needs to be transformed into a warm and happy hobbit hole. Okie dokie. We're building out three main rooms. There's a kitchen living area near the entrance, then a bunk room in the middle of the bunker, and a main bedroom with a queen-size bed in the far room near the exit shaft. All of which are going to have lights and electrical outlets like a normal residential home or RV. All of the welding and construction happening today is going to be underground, and since oxygen is rather important in an enclosed environment, we have to be careful where we get our electricity from. Not to mention how loud an engine would be inside of this large tin can, we can't very well run a gas-powered generator to power all our equipment. Gasoline has a shelf life of about 6 months anyway, so gas generators aren't the best solutions for long-term apocalyptic scenarios. We're going to be using the new EcoFlow DELTA Pro 3, a solar battery-powered generator that has a working life of 4,000 cycles, which means we should be able to run this thing every day for the next 11 years. Batteries have come a long way recently. This generator can output 4,000 watts, which is more than enough to power the 240-volt welder, while we erect the internal skeleton around the inner walls of the bunker. The flanges where we join the two tubes together have enough metal mass to absorb the heat from the liquefied welded metal without burning through to the exterior. At least that's what I'm hoping, since I'm not actually gonna dig up my backyard again to check. We'll have some thick metal straps bent and tucked in behind the long beams to keep them from shifting around, kind of like a barrel. And then to make this parallel with this inverted clamp. The inner devising walls are also going to be built from metal, which we just had laying around from when we started this project, and we might as well use it all up. Obviously, EcoFlow is probably gearing this solar generator more towards a home backup or emergency situations, but it's good that it can handle the heavy use of a construction site as well. We currently have the DELTA Pro 3 hooked up to 800 watts worth of flexible solar panels outside. It can accept up to 2600 watts, or charge from a normal wall outlet, or even a DC fast charger. And it's nice that we can run all of our equipment off of a single unit, because previously, in order to get 240 volts, we had to pair two EcoFlows up with a cable, but this DELTA Pro 3 can do 240 all in a single unit. The first side of the wall is up, the second side of the wall is super easy. Now for the header above the door frame. And in an actual emergency or apocalyptic situation where a gas generator would give away your position, this can output 2,000 watts at under 30 decibels, which is about the same loudness level as a whisper. They're calling it the X-Quiet technology, not to be confused with extinction level event. Anyone saying you need a gas generator for the apocalypse is probably just a zombie wanting to know your location. The elevator we installed is a lifesaver for bringing down equipment.
Got a sliver already.
We're going to frame out one singular vertical wall near where the kitchen will be. This is scrap wood that I reclaimed from some demolition we had at the wheelchair factory. This wall will eventually hold up the biggest TV we can fit through the door at some point, but that'll come later, one problem at a time. We are using the EcoFlow portable battery generator to install EcoFlow's permanent RV backup power kit, which should turn this bunker into a home. In my humble opinion, this is the easiest to install off-grid, off-the-shelf, plug-and-play battery system on the planet. The off-grid power kit gives us a normal breaker panel, normal wiring, normal outlets, and enough juice to live down here indefinitely if we need to, as long as the sun keeps shining above ground. It's a little bit of CAD cardboard aided design. That's what they call that.
Someone needs to appreciate how sick this is.
Come on, that's pretty good.
We're mounting the power kit in the living room area, right outside the bathroom wall. Inside the bathroom, we'll have an electric combustible toilet, and yeah, you heard that right, combustible. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. We have plenty of other problems to solve before we get to number two. We laid a piece of white FRP behind the control panel and the inverter. FRP is fiber-reinforced plastic, which smells terrible when cut, but looks very good. And its flexibility will make rounding the walls of the cylinder easy when it comes time for finish work. The 5 kilowatt-hour large stackable rectangular batteries in the power kit are permanent. There's no wheels or anything, they just get fixtured to whatever RV, cabin, or bunker they're installed in.
It is smoky, dude. Good thing we have the fan pulling air from the other side of the bunker. The air in here is circulating quite very well, so we're safe.
There's a chance that's right on a stud.
Didn't think about that, did we? Smells good, though.
We've been learning the hard way that it's super easy to bury a culvert bunker, but the circular shape makes it much more difficult to build out once it's in the ground. Luckily, the circular shape does give us plenty of storage under the deck. We'll use this to hold the food and water, but also we have some uniquely designed white PVC wiring ducts. You might be saying to yourself, hey Jerry, that wire duct looks a whole lot like a rain gutter from Home Depot, and I would say you are most definitely right. The gutter just keeps the wire suspended in the crawl space while providing a very organized layout for wire management. With all the wires lifted up and off the crawl space floor, we'll still have room for a very large water bladder and months worth of food storage, along with plenty of books and video games, because when the aliens arrive to wipe out humanity, at least we won't be bored. All the wires run through those gutters and then up into the walls we framed, just like in residential construction. We've cored out large holes in the metal wall studs with a mag drill. The mag drill uses a very powerful electromagnet to clamp itself onto a metal surface and brute force its way through thick pieces of material without much human effort required, just electricity. Romex gets pulled through metal studs and metal conduit every day, but we added rubber grommets to the inner edges just in case. Safety's always a good thing. And finally, all the wires come together inside of the normal breaker panel. There are 6 regular AC breakers and 12 DC fuses for a separate low voltage system. The DC side is much more efficient than the AC side, and we'll be tapping into the DC stuff later, but for now we're just wiring the AC.
That's freaking sweet. We're at 29% power, probably across both batteries. That is incredibly easy to set up.
You can see the Romex coming through on one side, just like a regular residential breaker panel. The 12 DC runs with their DC fuses are on the other half. These could be 12 or 24 volts, and we'll run these later.
She's looking pretty.
So pretty you're not going to get bullied in the comments?
I don't think so. Pretty nice.
This is the kitchen run, larger gauge. Obviously, this 10 kilowatt hour power kit is very much a permanent installation and not super portable. The Delta Pro 3, however, is extremely portable. It's 4 kilowatt hours and also stackable with expansion units, each of which are also 4 kilowatt hours.
Coming.
The wheels on the back and the carrying handle make it much easier to transport and move around. The portable Delta Pro 3 has four 120-volt outlets and a 240-volt plug. Keep in mind, though, that the 240 and 120 will not work at the same time. You gotta pick one or the other. The Delta Pro 3, however, can plug into our power kit and add its 4 kilowatt hours to the 10 kilowatt hours we have permanently installed. It's a pretty slick setup, and it's pretty awesome how well EcoFlow's products all work with each other. It functions down to a negative 10 degrees, has a 10 millisecond UPS response time to back up servers, routers, or security cameras, and internally it has an IP65 splash resistant battery pack, all with a 5-year warranty. We definitely aren't finished yet, but with our power source now in place, it'll make things much easier down here from now on. And if this video gets a million likes, I'll upgrade to a fusion core.
I feel like with electricity, if you do it right, nobody notices, but if you do it wrong, everything goes boom. Before the inspector comes though, let me show you what this thing is made from.
The first thing we have is a very portable and convenient carrying handle. That allows the Delta Pro 3 to be transported very easily. We have a color LCD screen up top, and then by clicking this button here, we have four 120-volt outlets. And by clicking the button over here, we enable the 240-volt with two different styles of plugs. Enabling the 240-volt does disable the 120. The ports on the back are all used for power distribution. Underneath the first door, which flops down and gets tucked away, is our regular charging cable from an outlet or the solar inputs. And the two ports on the right side are the extra battery ports for the expansion modules. And the largest port on the back is used to connect the Delta Pro 3 to a smart home panel 2 to back up your whole house. And in our last sliding door, we have the 30 amp RV plug. It is obviously an extremely impressive and very capable little unit. I'll leave a link down in the description. And I think I hear the inspector.
Third time's the charm. Here I come. Okay.
Welcome back. Things have changed.
Yeah. I feel like this doesn't feel like a bunker anymore. It feels like I'm in the back of a like oil tanker converted into a motorhome.
Alright. Not quite the vibe we were going for.
Okay.
So yeah, this is where the TV's gonna go over here. And then over here is going to be like the sink and the fridge and like the air system.
Little kitchenette.
Yeah. And then over here is going to be the combustible toilet.
Mm. Is that ADA?
It will be, yeah.
Is this the door?
Yeah, it'll be a sliding door.
Wow. Okay.
Go ahead and go into the other rooms and flip the switches.
Oh, what's this?
That's an in-ground outlet, so you can like plug stuff into it.
This is legit now. I can see the future.
Wanna flip the switch?
Okay. What fits in this space?
These are gonna be the bunk rooms.
Oh, okay. Did you try laying down flat so you could fit?
It'll be cozy. Yeah, so it's all run off of the batteries now. So there's permanent batteries with electrical wires run under the floor and everything.
That's cool.
We still have a lot of finish work to do, so obviously the walls aren't going to be this color. We need your input on, like, you know, what to put over the walls. Very much more built out than this. This is just temporary. Want to go into the last bedroom?
Yes. Okay. Wait, wasn't there a bed in
here? Yeah, we took it out. We didn't want it to start on fire.
Okay. Good choice.
Yeah. And right now it is 65 degrees Fahrenheit down here, which feels very good after having
so much nicer down here.
Yeah. Did you feel the temperature?
Yeah, and as I was dropping down, I was like, oh, thank goodness.
All right, what suggestions do you have for us?
We should get rid of that spider.
Oh, hi.
I'm just so excited. it. Like, it really is coming to life. This feels less sketchy. The more it's built out, the more legit it seems. So it's exciting. I love that it's already built out. Like, my brain is able to comprehend it better.
So it looks like with all the lights on, we're pulling right around 200 watts, and we would have around maybe 3 days worth of electricity with just the lights running.
We're thinking about putting like TVs up on the ceiling and then just kind of like mimicking the weather outside.
That would be cool.
So if it's like raining.
Harry Potter ceiling.
Exactly, yeah.
I love that.
If you want to grab one of your very own EcoFlow Delta Pro 3s, I'll leave a link for those down in the description. They have some massive deals going on right now. And Cambry, do you want to finish us off?
Thanks a ton for watching. We'll see you around.